Peace fam, it's Ayazria, and first of all, goddesses move in silence. That's why you give all the accolades to God, but goddess is also written on the Kemet walls as well. But that's another video. So my last video, I talked about woman is not God because woman is goddess. God is masculine. So woman can never be God. She is goddess. And I also talked about how, and gave proof how the woman was not created all alone and by herself. Okay, I showed you the sperm with its head and its tail and how it is the brain and the spinal cord. The brain being the head and the spinal cord being the tail. So the man is very important in creation, and the man is needed, okay? Also, you know, the man really, in reality, if you really think about it, the man carries the baby before we carry man. Think about that. I mean, the man carries the baby in his scrotum before we carry the baby in our bellies. Okay? So the egg doesn't come before the chicken, and the chicken doesn't come before the egg. There's no beginning and there's no ending to us, and we came in pairs. Also, since we're talking about the man providing the brain and the spinal cord for the baby, now we must talk about the woman providing the blood for the baby, because no human alive is without blood. Show me one, you can't. So, alright, also I have a fun critical thinking challenge for you men. Very, very fun. But before I get into that, I further talked about the sexual urges that women have for men and why they exist for the sake of procreation. Also, the nerve endings of the female hormones and why they're there, the anatomy of the woman and its purpose. And I also asked the question, if we came here alone and just randomly gave babies, all random and stuff, then why, I mean, were our sexual organs numb? Like, did we not feel sexual feelings then? Because those sexual feelings are only there for the men, so we can go ahead and procreate. That's the only reason why they're there. And then once men came up on the scene, did we just miraculously grew the sexual nerve endings that started having those sexual feelings for the men, so we can create the baby? Then I gave you proof that we had strong urges by sharing with you that I had female friends who explicitly talk about their urges for men, and when they were without for a long time sex, they would talk about how explicitly, I'm just being, you know, I'm trying to vibrate on a higher frequency with this video, even though we're talking about root chakra, things that we really should not be talking about right now. But yeah, I told you that. Then I reminded you of the Maury show and how he would show that some women would have sex each day of the month with a different man. So if it were 30 days of the month, they would have sex with 30 men, different men. Okay? Thereby proving that women have strong sexual urges in their birth canal and their clitoris. Okay, and you know, that's just for the continuation of humanity. So, you know, I talked about a lot of things that are really elementary. Now, I do want to have like this very, very fun critical thinking challenge. But before I do ask the men for this challenge, I must explain that while even though I like possess critical thinking, which is not gifted to men alone, I still come to you in my physical form because I am your balance. Woman is man's balance. That's another reason why Ma'at is the judge and jury, balances the scale. She's a woman, not a man. And no one questions that either. Like, Tahuti doesn't question Ma'at and looks at her in a way other than her being feminine. That's her job. Some of us have jobs on this earth, you know, and we were born with it. You know, the perfect conditions gave us this job, you know, and it's almost like when I was a child, we used to play That's My Car. When we saw a car that resonated with us and that we liked, we would say, "That's my car." And whoever said, "That's my car" first, in some sort of fun, creative reality, that was their car. You can't say that's your car when someone already said that was their car. You know, same thing with mine. And she lives within all of us, but I'm just saying. So, we are each other's balance. God, you are gifted with physical strength. Okay, so let's think about that for a second. You're gifted with the ability to lift a couple hundred pounds, some even 300 pounds. You don't think that the creators gave us something in equality? Something that is equal to your ability to lift 300 pounds? You just think that we were just randomly left out? No, there's balance. As above, so below. As within, so is the outer. There's balance. There's balance. We have something that we are gifted with, and that's fortitude. Some of you men have evolved, and you have fortitude as well. Okay, but we were given inner strength, okay? That's why you're able to lift a couple hundred pounds, and we are able to carry a 9-pound baby and then give birth to the 9-pound baby as well. Different strengths, different aspects of each other, but balanced. The God and Goddess couldn't have you being able to lift 300 pounds and just leave us out. It just wasn't going to be done, okay? You're able to lift things with your hands. Our minds, we use our minds and create creativity rather than our hands. But we both have brains. We have the ability to use our brains, but in different ways. Okay, so we use our brains the same way you do, but in a different aspect. You gods, you gather the information from the outside world and you bring it to your inside world. The goddess, she gathers information from her inside world via the way she feels about it, and then she brings it to the outside world. Okay, so we gather information differently, but we still both have brains, okay? And that's why a sister is the most dangerous weapon on the face of the planet. She can literally bring heaven or hell to your outside world. I know this because I have all brothers, okay? And they've been brought a lot of hell in their life, a lot of hell from the sisters. They really have. And it's really sad, you know, to see someone who you grew up with, have great concern and care for, be living in such hell. It's crazy, you know. And so, getting back to the topic of this video, though, brothers, you have the ability to bring intelligence to the sisters, and then, you know, if you make her feel amazing, she will bring that which you brought to her back out into the real outside world in some shape or form, be it life or a child. Okay, this is what I call God and goddess status, the ability to create and shape the outside world by overstanding and manipulating energy. This is why I say we should practice sacred sex in the form of focused, organized energy. Okay, but that's a different video. But a God definitely wants to get smart and knowledgeable and bring it back to his goddess with the understanding of her feelings as it relates to the energy in her goddess creativity brings. Okay, now I don't want to leave anything out, so I do have my handy clipboard, so I am reading from my clipboard that stuff that I wrote down. So, you know, I don't know what just fell on me, but anyway, something didn't fall on me, but whatever. So I'm seeing all of this stuff regarding the woman not having her cycle, and it's really making us feel ashamed and dirty and divided. It's dividing us. We don't want that. We don't want that. So I'm here to bring some balance. Okay. So let's have some balance and let's have some mod here. So the woman is not supposed to have her cycle. Everything has a cycle. There's a water cycle. This is where all of the elements are involved. Earth, water, fire, air. The earth holds the water, the fire evaporates, which is the sun evaporates the water and transforms it into gas. The gas forms the clouds, the wind blows the clouds and makes the now rain fall to the earth, where it either goes directly back into the ocean to repeat the same cycle, or it's absorbed into the earth as groundwater, where it eventually travels once again back to the ocean to repeat the same cycle. There's a circulatory cycle. The circulatory cycle is the cycle of your blood. Yes, the cycle of your blood. There goes that word again. So during this cycle of the blood, your heart and lungs are best friends. When I learned the circulatory system, I really started knowing that the creators were more than just creators, but were scientists. Because what happens in the circulatory system is your heart pumps your blood to your brain and organs. Your brain and organs uses the oxygen from the blood. The blood is now no longer red, but blue, since it has no oxygen. And here is like what really amazed me when I learned this, is the heart then pumps the blood to the lungs for the oxygen that it needs. The lungs then breathes in the air that we breathe and gives the blue blood oxygen and turns it right back red. And the process is repeated over and over again for as long as we live. We even got the rock cycle. When my African college professor presented to us that the rocks had a cycle, I was like, what? But yes, the rocks actually have a cycle. The rocks are either going to be igneous rocks, sedimentary rocks, or metamorphic rocks. And the way rocks are formed is the magma, by magma. Magma is pretty much hot lava. You do know that there is a sun above the earth as well as below the earth. As above, so below. So the magma, which is hot lava, forms, and once it cools, either by reaching the earth's surface or the sea surface, it turns into igneous rock. The igneous rock, over time, is either going to erode through weathering and turn into sedimentary rock, or through heat and pressure, it's going to change and turn into metamorphic rock. Then what happens is even the metamorphic rock eventually turns right back into sedimentary rock due to weathering and erosion, and then it eventually breaks up into smaller pieces. Then the sedimentary rock then cements and gets all compact, and then it eventually goes right back to the bottom of the earth where it is heated once again and turned into magma, and then the cycle starts over again. So the woman is not supposed to have her cycle. Everything has a cycle. The earth has a cycle. We call it seasons. The moon has a cycle as well. We call it the lunar cycle. The lunar cycle is where the magnetic energy of the moon is either increased or decreased. And this magnetic energy controls all waters of the earth, including man and woman and ocean, since man and woman is 75% water. So you could have a circulatory cycle with your circulatory system, which is the cycle of blood, a blood cycle. The water gets to have a water cycle. The earth gets to cycle around the sun and have an earth cycle, which we call seasons. The moon gets to have a lunar cycle each and every month. And even the rocks get to have a cycle. But the womb cannot have a menstrual cycle. That to a girl, growing into a woman is the best cycle of them all. It means that you are now changing from girl to woman. It's the best cycle of them all. Your body then, each month, it renews eggs, drops them, releases them, removes them, along with any toxins. Then it brings forth new eggs, new blood, new information in the DNA. Brand new everything. Better, evolved, brand new, clean. But the woman isn't supposed to have a cycle. No. So, okay. Since the woman is not supposed to produce new blood for the new baby, and provide for the baby new information that she receives each month that she has gathered for this new baby. Let's create a critical thinking challenge for the men. Okay? Let's say a girl is normally supposed to start her period about, let's say 15, okay? Let's say the average age of getting married and having children is 25. So with those numbers, there is a 10-year difference, okay? Okay? And since the egg is what the woman has and releases, and the sperm is what the man has and releases, let's take that 10 years with the balance of Mayotte, the 10 years that a woman is not supposed to release her egg, and give that same 10 years to the man. Balance. Let's challenge you guys to keep the same old toxic sperm in your body for 10 years till you are ready to have a baby. We do realize that certain things not yet dead brings toxins to our food, air, and water. Our bodies absorb these things, and then it works really, really hard to get rid of them. So if every woman is supposed to keep their same old egg, and every man is supposed to keep his same sperm, because it's balanced, right? For 10 years or more, What do you think will happen to the body? The body will become more toxic, unhealthy, might even die. And if there's a baby produced, no new information or DNA to evolve humanity will be given to that baby. And since your egg and sperm is not renewing, guess what it's doing? It's aging, like you are. It's aging, okay? And so what about the baby that uses that old egg and that old sperm? Now that baby is born with toxins, no new information, 10 years worth of really 20 years worth of toxins, 10 years of toxins from the mom, and 10 years of toxins from the dad. Okay. So as I stated before, I am balance. We all have brains. The woman has a brain. The man has a brain. We use them differently. So, you know, how would that baby look? How would that baby even look? I almost forgot to ask that question. How would that baby look? So stop. Please. You have been watching Ayashria Aaliyah. Don't forget to like, subscribe, or share. Also, visit me at coppardaboriginals.org.